Hi, it's Miss Donna with Raleigh Parks Recreation and Cultural Resources. This video is part of our At Home with Nature series, Animals and Their Habitats. We're here at a pond, and a pond is a habitat. We know a habitat is a place where plants and animals live. And oftentimes when we look at a pond, we'll see plants growing along the edges of the pond. And there are a lot of animals that live in ponds. Maybe you can think of some. Maybe you've seen ducks swimming in the pond, or maybe you've seen a lodge, a beaver lodge, right in the middle of a pond. Maybe you've heard frogs. Maybe you've seen turtles in a pond, maybe swimming in the water, or maybe sunning themselves at the pond's edge. Maybe you like to go fishing, and if so, I'm sure if you go fishing at a pond, you're hoping there are fish living in the water. Ponds are beautiful habitats filled with life. We know that every habitat needs to provide things for the animals that live there. You know, habitat needs to provide water, and the water in a pond is fresh water, so it's not salty like ocean water. And the water in a pond is still water, so it's not water that's moving like a river or a stream. And our habitats need to also provide shelter for the animals that live within it. So animals here at the pond might find shelter among the plants around the edges of the pond, or they might find shelter in the muddy bottom of the pond. Animals also need space in their habitat. And a pond might not be as big as a lake, but it can be just the right size to provide space for a family of ducks and for a whole army of frogs. You probably hear some as I speak to you today from this pond's edge. They're noisy creatures. We also know that animals need food in their habitats. And as a matter of fact, all animals and plants are linked together in a food chain in a habitat. So what's a food chain? Well, it's that connection between plants and animals in a common habitat. And, you know, here at this pond, we've got some plants that are going to begin our food chain. We've got a certain kind of plant. I'm sure you've seen this before. It's called algae, and it oftentimes floats on our ponds. And I know that plants are living things, and they need energy, so they need food too, but plants make their own food. Green plants do. They use parts of our air, they use sunlight, they use water, and they make food, so they're called producers. Plants begin all our food chains because they can make their own food, but they're creatures that are eating this algae, this plant that lives here in the pond. Maybe you can think of the animal that's going to eat the algae. It's a creature that hatched from an egg, and it's going to grow up to be either a frog or toad. Do you know who it is? Did you guess a tadpole? You're right. Tadpoles eat algae. But wait, there are creatures that want to eat tadpoles. So better watch out, tadpole. Got a creature that wants to eat the tadpole that it hatches from an egg, and it breathes using gills within the water. So it uses its gills to take in oxygen from the water, but it does so its whole life. It's not going to leave the pond one day like the adult frogs and toads. So you know who this creature is that's going to eat the tadpole. It's a fish. And fish like to eat tadpoles, and the tadpoles like to eat the algae. Everybody eats. That's a food chain. But there's a creature who wants to eat the fish. And it's a creature that's a reptile and has no arms or legs. Do you know who it is? Yes, it's a northern banded water snake, in this picture is. So a water snake would like to eat the fish that's eating the tadpole, that's eating the algae everybody eats. So I wonder who's gonna eat the snake. This creature, it sits in a tree above the pond and watches and waits until it sees that water snake slithering around and moving around the water. So, see who it is. It's a creature that's gonna fly down and grab the snake with its very sharp talons or claws. It's a hawk. So, that red-tailed hawk is in a good position. He's at the top of the food chain. He doesn't have another animal who's going to try to eat him. But we know that all living things will eventually finish their lives. When they do, their bodies decompose. And that energy is returned to the producers, to the plants. So it's like a cycle, isn't it? Yes. So food chains, everybody eats. Nobody wants to get eaten, but everybody eats. So there's a lot happening in a pond. I want to see some pond creatures. How about you? Do you want to see some? I'm going to show you our first creature. It's a creature that is an insect, so it has six legs, and it's a creature that you probably have seen by the pond. It's got lacy wings and pretty colored abdomens, and it zip flies. It moves around well with those wings. It can even fly backwards, and it eats midair too. These are great creatures to watch when you're exploring a pond, but it doesn't always look like that. You figured it out. I'm talking about dragonflies. But when dragonflies begin their lives, when they hatch from eggs in the water, they don't look at all like a grown-up dragonfly. They look like this. This is called a dragonfly nymph. It's a baby dragonfly. And sometimes people see these in the pond and they think it's a spider. But spiders have eight legs, and he's just got six legs here. And he's gonna eat, at first he's gonna eat algae, and he's gonna grow. And as he eats and grows, his skin becomes too tight. That's his exoskeleton. So he has to zip it off. And underneath, he's got more fresh skin that fits better. So he eats more. And as he grows, he starts to eat bugs and other plants besides algae living in the pond water. And eventually he's gonna be ready to be an adult. So he moves to a blade of grass by the edge of the pond. And this time when he breaks open his exoskeleton, wow, underneath he has wings. He has that beautiful colored bottom body part called an abdomen. It's some big changing, isn't it? Got an adult dragonfly here. That's big changes. That's called metamorphosis. Wow. We've got some other creatures that live in the pond as well. Let's see, I tried very hard when I arrived here at the pond. I wanted to find a big fish to show you, but it got away. So I have some small fish that I was able to find. I'm gonna hold them up here. I don't want to take them out of the container because they're small fish, and they can't breathe when they're out of the water. They take in their oxygen using gills underwater. So we need to keep them in there. We know that fish are cold-blooded. We know most fish have scales. We know most fish have fins that help them to swim. They've got eyes on the sides of their head. That lets them look all around because they've got to be watchful. Fish this size would be good food for bigger fish. So they hope not to be food. They want to live their lives as long as they can. So we've seen some dragonflies. We've seen some fish. Got another creature here. This is a pretty famous pond creature that you'll know who he is when you see him. He's wiggly. He's got a tail. He's not a fish. He's a tadpole. He's a baby frog. This is a bullfrog tadpole that I have in my hand. He hatched from an egg, and he is eating algae and growing well. And depending upon the type of tadpole it is, sometimes it takes 6 weeks, sometimes it can take 2 years. But eventually back legs will grow. And I've got a tadpole here with some back legs I want to show you. He's a jumper. He's using those back legs to jump in my hand here. See if you can see him. He's got really good back legs. He's even got webbed feet already. No front legs though. He still has his tail. So he's a tadpole with back legs. That's our first big change for the tadpoles. So now he's not breathing underwater. His gills have clogged up when his back legs have grown to this size. So now he has to come up out of the water and get a gulp of air and then swim back under the water. And about 4 weeks from now, he's going to show us some front legs. And I've got some froglets here. They've got front legs and back legs. I've got two of them in this container I found today here in the pond. And maybe you can see they've got little front legs and nice sized back legs. and they still have their tails. One of the two, its tail is starting to be absorbed within the body of the froglet. So the tail doesn't fall off. It's absorbed inside the body, and eventually there'll be no tail at all. We'll have a grown frog. Sometimes tadpoles will become grown toads. If they're a toad, they're going to leave the pond once they're grown and they're going to move to the forest area. But the mama toad is going to come back to the pond when she's ready to lay eggs. There's a whole group of frogs that move to the forest as well. They're called tree frogs. There's a whole family of those. But eventually they're going to come back to, the mamas are going to come back to the pond in order to lay eggs. So it's great to see all those big changes that our frogs and toads go through. That, just like with the dragonfly, is metamorphosis, big changing. So we've got another creature here. He wants very much to come and have you see him. He's been making some noises down here at my feet. We've got these living in the pond. These are some of my favorite creatures. Is it a turtle? This is a musk turtle, and he lives in the mud at the edge of the pond. He is right at home there. He's the same color as the mud, so he's camouflaged well to be protected in the habitat. Again, that food chain. Everybody eats, but nobody wants to get eaten. So you have ways to keep yourself from being eaten, and one of them is to blend in or be camouflaged. Our musk turtle shows that clever way very well with its brown shell. He's got a top shell that's brown. It's called his carapace. And let's see underneath. Does he have a shell under there? It's a tiny shell, isn't it? He's got some big feet and big arms. He's got webbed feet, and that undershell, that plastron, is very small to accommodate those big muscular legs. He's a good swimmer. So he's got a striped face, and I notice on his face there, he's got a beak-like mouth. So turtles don't have teeth. They have a beak-like mouth for gathering food and chewing it and breaking it up. And musk turtles like to eat plants. They also like to eat bugs that they find in the pond. I see him poking out his head right there. In the wintertime, we don't see turtles at the pond. They go to the mud down below the pond, and they sleep through the winter. It's called brumation. That's a pretty exciting thing to do. So now his head is all the way out. He's a great creature. You know, sometimes when we see a pond, we might think, that's just a still body of water. But don't be fooled. There are lots of amazing creatures that live in ponds. Next time you're at a pond, just take a close look and you'll see.